competition of Anthicon 2024! Man, it is such an awesome sight. I can't get enough of this every time. Can't you, Humphrey?
I'll tell you. For those of you that don't know, I'm actually with the safety division as well. And we were looking around at everybody, and the first thing that my guys were saying is, where did you all come from? There's too many of you.
Yeah,
and I mean, right now, I can see them all the way back to where AV is. It's crazy.
It's awesome. It reminds me of that scene from The Lion King where everything that light touches is our kingdom. Just not back there. That's the AV booth.
No.
Yeah, but honestly, what? I'm just a noodle. I don't know what I'm talking about. It's so good to see everybody here today, and I'm sure many of you have been here before, but for those that haven't and it's their first time, you're in for a treat, because we've got 26 of the Fandom's Best Fursuit Dance Competition performers that are going to come up on this beautiful stage, set up by that same AV crew, and they're going to be dancing their hearts out for all of you and hearing the awesome feedback from our judges who will ultimately decide who our top performers are for today. So, I think, with that being said, do we want to, actually tell the audience who some of our judges are? You know a few of them as well as I do, right?
Well, first, let me just get your noodles in. There you go.
Oh, man, in front of everyone He's like that?
He's getting hungry over here, trying to eat the noodles.
Yeah, two whole noodles for breakfast.
So, let's go ahead and start it off. Our lovely judges have proven themselves time and time again that they're going to be... What in the hell is going on? I blame one of my closest friends, I blame you in anything. Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Gail Frostbane.
And sitting right next to Gail Frostbane is another veteran faced in the furry dance competition scene who has been the winner of numerous dance competitions and has judged and hosted many. It is none other than JD Puppy. And beside JD Puppy is also someone who is very familiar with Anthicon's dance competition and somebody who is on their very first judging stint. Everybody, please make some noise for Kathy!
Let's just actually clear it up. It's Atsu Fox, okay?
Atsu Fox.
Are you a Jersey member now?
Yeah, I'm from Joyzy. Alright, we're gonna do Joyzy action from now on. But who do we have as our last but foremost not least judge? Who is that over there, Humphrey?
I've seen this person come up in the world, and they're actually.
Oh.
They are one that has brought tap back. And made it so that I've seen people actually respond to not only all these judges because it's well deserved, but this wonderful individual has tapped his way into all of our hearts. Ladies and gentlemen, Mezcal.
Mezcal kind of won last year's competition, isn't that right?
He did.
Yeah, so we've got our returning champion, almost you could say the defending champion, but today Mezcal is here as a judge. And all four of these judges are going to be looking at all of the talent that's about to come up on stage right now and, again, find out who the top places and honors are.
And they're going to regret being there.
They're going to
regret. Because this is going to be a very tight competition. As former judges, Ronnie and I, we both agree, we are sorry in advance.
The Canadian is sorry, not sorry. Sorry.
All right, who do we have that's going to be coming out to start the show first?
Well, we have a little bit of a switch up that's happening. So
that's
just
right.
Just to let our AV friends in the back know, but we have again a roster of 26 amazing performers, and the first one is coming out here with a mix that I would say is pretty much. Okay, you gotta hear it for yourselves, because you can only find this kind of mix at Anthicon's dance competition. Everybody, please give a huge welcome to Arca!
We're before I start, I want to thank everybody, especially Jezza and Brenda, who gave me feedback and encouraged me not to give up along the way. This is a dream come true, and I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you.
What's up, guys? These are the top 5 things to never do in a fursuit dance competition. Number 5, try rapping for the first time.
Still working at the AC dance comp, trying to hit my dream, so I'm really getting out of breath, hard not to pant when I put here in the spot. My kicks are a little bit fishy, put it all together, you can call me Mark and Marcha. I'm a GSD, run with me, play with me, I'm pepper like Kylie, so you better match my energy. I'm a little doggy, I go to a fart horse. I'm a little doggy, I like to a fart horse. I'm a little doggy, I like to woof.
Number 4, dance to the most hated song ever. Number 3, forget your choreography.
Somebody on that stage has some feelings about that.
Yes, they do.
Ooh, bad. Don't do it. I'm not the one judging you, but that was really rad, except for the dabbing.
We'll start off with Mezcal on this one.
Thank you for opening the show, Arca. That was very fun and playful. Absolutely love the energy that you gave. I think the audience can very much agree with that. One of the things that I think you can work on going forward, when you are really working on movement that's focusing on your lower body, try and still engage your upper body a little bit. There are moments where your arms were down by your sides and the energy wasn't necessarily fully there. They were a little bit hanging and sometimes a little bit stiff. So make sure you're finding that fluidity, having energy go out to all your points. Even if your arms are still at your sides, there are ways you can still do that with having your energy going all the way through. But thank you so much.
Everybody, one more time for Arca! Arca, for providing all the memes for the next 5 years. We definitely don't need any more memes. And unless it's like the little Wiggly Fox, that's a good meme.
It's funny because they were wearing the sunglasses and they actually had sunglasses around. I know, so they didn't forget what they had.
Arca even brought back the Kanye shades. Like, that's crazy. All the way from 15 years ago.
You look like a very educated noodle with yours on, so we just gotta...
Yeah!
Doesn't Ryan look good with those glasses on, folks?
Yeah, I got it because I know what 2+2 means. It means fish.
Yes. Now if they only knew the truth.
Friend fish.
Well, I don't think this is a competition about who looks better, though, although I could say that you and I would be close to close, or neck to neck. But I think it is a competition for dancing, and
yes,
our audience here wants to see who the next dancer is.
This dancer was actually very surprising to see how well they've grown over the last little bit. You may have seen them at other competitions before, you may have not. Give all your energy you can, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the stage, Horizon!
Sometimes gotta let it go. Sometimes gotta look away. Sometimes just gotta know when to stick your middle finger up in the air. Tell you how I feel. Life is just a game. and I play for the win. Don't be scared to say just what you think. Cause no matter how bad, someone's listening.
Say so myself, don't you think, Humphrey?
Very much. I'm a fan of
yeah,
one of
and
these
a squirrel.
Kids.
That's not squirrel with like all those fancy letters. It's like S-Q-O-R-L. See, I can spell.
I told you the glasses were there for looks.
So, judges, what do we think of our little squirrel friend's performance here?
Hello, Horizon. You looked like you wanted, you did everything you wanted to do. I loved your cutting, and you hit all of the beats that I feel like you really pushed to hit. The only thing I'd say is to, with certain parts, I feel like your energy could have been higher, and you could have really, like, punched out to different beats, but other than that, I feel like you did awesome.
Yeah, I think that was a punchy performance for sure. Everyone, give it up for Horizon.
When we told you that this show was going to be fire, those are just two dancers. And out of 26, this show is blowing my mind how wonderful these dancers are. And if you ever want to try out, we're always looking for new people. There was a couple of dancers from before who were basically
tall. They're getting younger and younger every year. It's like they start off down that tall, and then their skill level goes all the way up here. So this is open for anyone that is, you know, willing to put in the effort to be part of First Year Dance Comp, and you might make your stage here one day, make your way up to the stage.
Yeah, and put us in a retirement home, which we wouldn't mind.
Well, I guess we'll just have to see how many of these dancers do just that. So do we know who our next dancer is?
So this next dancer is one that I've brought up and a hold dear to my heart. She's a very, very close friend of mine. You'll hear the name, and I just want to hear the energy for all these dancers, but this one too. Ladies and gentlemen, my pleasure, Zero!
Yeah. big bios, big bios. Sitting here, big dials. $90 for the models when I'm big dials. Be my wallet out this market, I'm 6 foot. I spend all my money, I be 6 foot. All my f***ing crypto on the market, take a dip. Ooh, 20K of chip, look. 20 now we out there, so plus I got my whole song around me like I did. Stand by the artist, so it's hard to hurt it. People out the curve, and I'm the murder, got the word. Never let that bird in that shit that trip with a curve. And if they wanna get f***ing, I'll turn them to the server. And say, yes, I'm that king. Yeah, I'm that king.
Let's give it up for Zero!
Wow! Zero with all of his smart tech. Hey, whoa, 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 whoa. Wow! The rat upgraded. It's now like rat squared. That's how math works, right?
Sure.
Okay, for squared rats and stuff.
Katie, please.
So you, usually when something encounters an upgrade, it goes from 1.0 to 2.0 as opposed
rat
to...
Rat 2.0, woo!
There we go. All right. Zero, it's such a clear expression of the style that you wanted to put out, especially matching the character and its appearance. Like, you went hard in a way that really translated what that attitude and personality of the character is, even beyond just the choreography of the dance. So it's that amalgamation of really strong dance expression with really strong character expression that I really enjoyed. The things that I can mention are really, like, nitpicky things. Like, yes, the style has a lot of fist moments, and because of the different coloration of your fingers, you could accentuate it a lot more by having more extension moments, but that's super small, right? Yeah, like anytime that you get a chance to show off your hands, super awesome. Like head flicks and stuff like that, just being able to put that in a way that like just accentuates the choreography even more. I'm literally just nitpicking, trying to find additional things to say on top of an awesome performance. So thank you so much, Zero.
It was. Thank you. Zero.
I like when Jamie was saying, like, accentuate those hands, and I'm like, does he mean the beads? Because beans are like the best thing ever. Everybody should show off their beans.
Yes, they are.
Yeah, for sure. Well, speaking of showing off, I think our next dancer is going to show off something that I don't think the crowd is ready to see, because this dancer happens to be something of what's known as a b-boy. And a b-boy, for some of you that don't know, stands for a break boy, somebody that is well versed in the art of breaking, or break dancing as more commonly known as. But not just a connoisseur of the art of b-boy, this next dancer also happens to come all the way from the land of the rising sun, from halfway across the world all the way to you straight from Japan. Everyone make some noise for Lucidio!
Yeah.
professional people.
But I see you serious-eyed. Everybody, what did you think from our friend all the way from Japan? Did you like that? I'll tell you right now, I'm sharing a bit of a personal tidbit that I got to see Lil Seryu here back at J-Moth in January this year, but I also saw a whole bunch of Japanese dancers, and I'll tell you now, right now, crowd, if you thought that the talent pool here on our side of the planet is amazing, I hope all of you get the chance to see what it's like elsewhere in the world, because Lil Seryu here is just a small taste of what the furry fandom internationally and all the talents they have is like. So let's show some more support for all of our international furs. What
yes.
do you say, Humphrey?
And with that, who else better to judge that than our own Gail? Gail, tell us what you think of these Japanese representatives.
Oh my gosh, I am just over the moon. I'm so unbelievably happy that you're here. Thank you so much for coming all the way over to share your dance with us. You are just an incredible, incredible breaker. It was such a pleasure to also watch you in Floor Wars last night. You did phenomenal. The way that you are able to do the stuff that you do, which is, and breaking is a very difficult art form, and to be able to do that in a full digigrade fursuit with a big tail is seriously stunning. It really shows that you put the work into your craft. I would say that there were just some moments where it felt like you didn't commit all the way, and that some of that could have been the stage arrangement. But seriously, that was fantastic, and you are such a joy to watch, and I cannot wait to just watch you more and more and more, especially on the live streams of all of the events over in Asia as well.
I think everyone here agrees with that. Everybody, give it up one more time. Arigato gozaimasu.
Well, it's really good to see folks from around the world come together. And I will say, and I think you can confirm with me, AnthroCon itself is a one place all over the world we can come together. We have 30, as far as I remember, 39 countries represented in AnthroCon this year.
Yeah.
At least. So, please, it's just one big family. I can't even have words.
Absolutely. And, you know, speaking of that family, I'm pretty sure that the next dancer that we've got coming up is some of the, you know, I would say you would call it la familia, or like the fam in terms of the dancer circle, someone who's been stuck in around for a long time and really just interconnected with so many folks within this dancer fur community, as we call it. So, Humphrey, who is this next dancer we've got coming up?
So this next dancer is not only a delicious soup, but has taken our hearts for, well, no noodles included, but has taken our hearts many times when they come up on this stage. Absolutely beautiful work. Ladies and gentlemen, miso!
Cause you got it in a daily.
Oh, my, oh my, miso. What a delicious performance. I mean, if I like just stick to you like this, are we miso noodle soup?
Now it's a good meal.
Now it's a whole meal.
It's a whole meal.
Make sure y'all are eating 2 meals a day at least.
No noodles.
Well, judges, aside from thinking delicious thoughts about what you're going to have for lunch after this performance, what do you think of this miso and how delectable their dance was?
Hi, miso. So, absolutely loved your performance. What I really enjoy about what you did tonight is you really matched the music. Every time there was a texture change within the music, you matched that with your movement, whether that was super intense with really high bass or if it was a little bit softer. I really, really enjoyed how you did that. One thing I think you could definitely improve on is I wanted to see you have more thoughtful utilization of the stage. A lot of it was really stationary and center stage. You had small little moments where you like walked slightly to stage left and slightly to stage right. I wanted you to try and think about really filling out that space, having more than just like I'm here now and I'm here now. Really think about that whole utilization. Other than that, thank you so much. It was a pleasure to watch.
Woo! Crowd! Give it up! Well, here we go! Yeah, we'll grab lunch together. Don't worry. We won't be lunch. We'll grab lunch together.
Well, at least miso would be a wonderful addition to all this beautiful-looking food that we have on our stage.
Yeah, I mean, wow, this is a pretty nice-looking stage. I got, like, lemonade and little things. And so, wow, I'm getting really hungry.
As long as I keep them away from the darks, we'll be okay.
Can we take a snack break real quick? I want to get some lemonade.
Go ahead.
Okay, well, wait, there's no lemonade. You're telling me the lemonade was a lie?
Yes, it's a lie.
Wow, I don't even want to know what's in those jokes anymore. Well, I guess no snack break for me, so I guess we'll just have to call our next dancers out.
Right.
Yeah.
So, you've seen solo dancers, mm-hmm. but we also have duets and or what we call group performances. And this next group, I'm excited for you to see today. Who do we have running?
Oh, this next group, I think as soon as we call them on stage, people that have been at Anthicon's DanceCon for a long time will instantly know just how explosive of a competition this is about to become. Are you stealing the lemonade?
He's stealing it.
The lemonade really is a lie. But you know what's not a lie? Is the power of this next team performance that we've got coming up. So everybody, you better make a lot of noise for Jamage and Atsu!
Louis called Cafe.
Did you win the prize? Did you win the prize? Here's the prize I got for you.
No tickets.
I just got it. Ready?
No tickets needed.
Emotional damage.
Oh.
Well, all I can say is that was cleaner than Mr. Clean. You might put Mr. Clean out of a job with how clean that performance was. Jamage and Atsu.
Unbelievable.
My goodness. Two powerhouses in the dance comp scene, and now they're combining forces, which should totally be, like, illegal and stuff.
We should have a warning label.
But, you know, I'm not gonna let my opinions influence how they did. I'm gonna let the judges tell us what they thought about Jamage and Atsu. So, judges.
Because you're next.
I love the little cute Louis skit in the beginning. You guys were in sync pretty much the entire time. You guys were like liquid up there with their waving. It was so awesome. Everything was on point. The only critique I feel like I have is like a few little parts you guys were off, but everything else was great.
Made you speechless, right?
And I need more from you two.
Yeah, you yes. Almost broke Kepi, so, or Kepi, sorry. Sorry! I'm sorry!
Ow.
Okay, listen,
ow.
Okay, blame the Canadian in here, right?
Every
Canadian accent's coming out.
Great song that was a side to Atsu 5.
Yeah, at least we got that one.
Dude, be a side to Atsu 5.
Sorry, Atsu Fox. No, I'm kidding.
Crowd, did you want to see this again next time if they do it again? Let's give it up one more time for Atsu and Jimmy!
Wow. Team performances really are something else, aren't they, Humphrey?
It really fills my heart to see if not only some of the dancers that we were when we first started is still doing this, but these newer dancers, which is our next dancer, is a one that I haven't personally heard of, but I saw their tryouts and it was mind-blowing. I just want you to see it. It's absolutely beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, Soren Skye! Having that nice fluid motion, I would love to hear sure what the judges have to say. JD, please.
The fluid motion, I think, was a really great descriptor of it right from the get-go, and really leveraging a very strong and powerful entrance, really strong and powerful choreography all the way through. Something that I talk about a lot in my critiques is often about how dancers choose good silhouettes on the stage, creating those picture moments that if you were to just take a snapshot or just even your shadow of what your body position is throughout the routine, you were delivering silhouette after silhouette after silhouette, and pretty seamless transitions between those with really nice, elegantly put together choreography. There were a couple of places inside the routine where in the floor work, I wasn't sure if there, with the way that the stage is, if there was, there were a couple of intentional moves in there that might have translated differently than would have been ideal, but I still think that you were able to move through those in a way that still got you to where you needed to be. I will say that most of the stuff that you did while on your feet was executed incredibly strongly, and I'm not sure if it's just because of the way that the stage is, that some of the groundwork looked a little weaker to me. However, it was a very thoroughly, it was very well executed in terms of choreography, and I always really enjoy seeing you deliver great pictures for us on stage. Thank you so much, Lauren Sky.
It'll be a picture for our memories. Let's give it up one more time for Soren Sky!
Soren Sky, part of what I would say is sort of the more newer upcoming crowd to dance off stage.
That's a name you're going to have to remember.
Absolutely. We'll see them again. You're going to see a lot of these new talents coming on stage more and more because, well, frankly put, our community is just really big at this point. It's like, people keep on asking me how big the convention is this weekend, and the only answer I can give them is yes.
Because, I'll be honest with you, since Ronnie and I, you know, we've been keeping track a little bit of what it is, you all scare us.
Yeah.
Stop being so big and scary, all of you. But thank you?
Yeah. Stop scaring us so nicely, you.
But out of all the people we have, I know this next dancer is wonderful, but I think you know them just as well.
Well, I think this next dancer is going to counter what you said earlier about no noodles being on stage, because this one's about to bring some extra noodles in. I'm going to be really, really excited for this one. There goes my glasses. I'm going to be really excited so much I lose my glasses, because we're going to bring some more talented noodles on stage. Everyone, give it up for Fritz Trashin!
Thank you.
right here? These things right here? Yeah, this makes you dance better. Sources, trust me, bro.
Oh. Okay, I'm going.
Woo! Power of noodles, yay! So,
I saw the judge's face go down, and they're just like, oh no, I gotta judge, I have to go wonderful.
Listen, I know the next judge who's about to speak, and I know that she would be a fan of growing some noodles herself, so she could be as cute as Fritz up here.
Yes.
Isn't that right, Gail?
I want to tee up into a dragon.
Who does it?
White man. That's how tee up works. Okay, seriously though, Fritz. Wow. I'm trying to not be emotional about this because we've known each other for so long, but like we're finally just getting to meet and hang out in person at this con, and like you're my wow buddy, you my rogue, but your dancing is so beautiful, it's so emotive, the way that you took that song and broke it down, and the way that you played with the instrumental strings throughout that song and translated it into your movements was just stunning. Absolutely stunning. It is incredible to finally watch you dance in person and to be able to bring this fursuit to life. It's such a stunning suit. The long pile fur, the noodles, the tail, it all moves so well with your movements because you're so good at dancing in fursuit. And I'm so proud of you. My minor nitpicks are I would like to see more intentional moments of slowness. And I think in the future, that type of song style would also do really well with like a ballet flourish. But seriously, I love you. And I'm so proud of you. Thank you so much.
Heartstrings all around. Let's give it one more time.
One more time for the Noodle Power. Is working. We already got Gail. Everyone else is next.
All right. Yeah. Well, you're not supposed to dry your tears on the puppy next to you. I'm sorry. You're not supposed to.
Yeah. That right there is a puppy that is meant for happy tears, not emotional.
It's your emotional.
Tears.
Oh. Okay. All right. Well, we're gonna keep this moving. This next dancer we have we've seen him from when they first came in and now leaps and bounds. That's for all the dancers, but. As a Papa Lock guy myself, there's a couple of these dancers I look after pretty well. Very proud of this one.
Yeah.
It's my honor to introduce to you, Ronnie!
Can't let you go. Betcha, won't be looking jump and water.
can always rely on Ronnie to deliver a championship level performance. That is guaranteed. I also think you can count on Ronnie to just like stop time and space. As we error for.
I caught him.
Ronnie.exe has stopped working.
Yep. Please remove Doggo.
It's Sunday. We see like .exes have stopped working all the time. I think half of the lobby of the hotels over there have .exes stopped working.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, someone's gotta be doing the con. Start the con all over again. You guys wanna start the con all over again?
Yeah! No!
I love how it's like the staff are like, no! And everyone's like, yes.
The staff says, I quit. I'm done. Yeah.
Pretty much.
So, Mescal, please don't quit on this, and I'm sorry about all this.
Yeah, please don't quit. Yeah. We need y'all. But before we get to our week-long convention that nobody on staff wants, we want to hear from the judges about what they thought about
Judge
Ronnie's performance.
Your footwork is always so clean, and I know it's hard to do in those feet, but you always execute it really well. I feel like every time I had critique, You did it in the moment. The only thing I'd say is you do a lot of outward and stuff, but like come up here, come down a little bit. But yes. But other than that, keep it up.
Lovely. Let's hear it. Welcome back, Ronnie. All right. So Ronnie, as we were kind of talking about before, is part of the veteran dancer crowd
yes,
at this point.
Yes.
Many of you out here would have remembered seeing Ronnie veteran on Epicon stage many, many times before, and many others. Yeah, it's exactly. The snap crackle popped my hip from last night. If you're at Four Wars, you would understand that reference. But, oh yeah, by the way, who was at Four Wars last night?
Let me hear it.
Yeah.
Did you all enjoy it?
Yeah. An awesome show, and lots of dancers in Floor Wars are also in this dance competition.
Yes, they are.
Because, well, the skill level of both events just keeps getting higher and higher, and it's starting to show who really is putting in more of that work and commitment. And this next dancer that we've got coming out has not only done their very first Floor Wars last night, and is about to do their very first dance competition tonight, but this is their very first AntherCon ever.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
So they are already showing how much commitment and passion they have for their art form by making it all the way up here. And I'm so honored to introduce them. Everybody, a huge round of applause for Wolfgang! Yeah.
Thank you.
goodness.
A well-deserved bow at that. My goodness.
Absolutely, crowd. Did you expect that performance, crowd?
Let's hear it. Now I will say
that is the picture-perfect definition of elegance on our stage.
We've had a lot of ballet dancers, and some of the senior dancers won't understand this. Kato and a few others that we had with the ballet have made the way for this, and if this is what we're going to get, please keep bringing it. That was emotional and beautiful. So, I also want to hear what the judges have to say, because I'm smitten.
Good luck, judges!
Yeah, good luck!
Exactly. I mean, I think the audience roaring applause that came out during and throughout the performance and after the performance really speaks for itself. I really like the way that you put it, Humphrey. Like, there's a place for every kind of dance style in an all-styles event like this, and just it's like I've loved seeing the surgence of a lot of really great street expression that's out there, but there's also so much space for elegant and in studio trained type stuff in that scene too, ballet, jazz, contemporary, and so on and so forth. There's space for all of that. And so to just go out there and confidently put out what your craft is, what your passion is, regardless of whether it is crump, ballet, b-boy, like we're seeing such a wide variety here, and you bring that level of execution in your craft of ballet is just absolutely breathtaking, absolutely astonishing.
Very much.
Yeah. So thank you so much.
Thank you so much, JD. Exactly like what Jamie said, the diversity of the styles in this dance competition, I mean, we can say that that reflects the diversity of our furry community that we've got here at Anthrocon.
It does. And it just like all of you, how this family kind of brings everybody together and have inclusion no matter what it is. JD's right. Just everybody has their own place, and that's what makes it beautiful, especially with the dancers. You can have crump, b-boy, ballet, pop and lock, it doesn't matter. It's just emotional all around. It is so fun. But I also have a dancer that's coming up next. One that you and I have watched come into this Phantom and basically
I think I know who it is.
Destroys all logic to movement. As a pop and lock with my character Nero, I saw them come in and basically said, I quit. I'm done. But I want to see them continue more. And just, it is absolutely beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, a friend of mine, Matroda!
And I gotta tell the crowd right now, I don't know if the crowd was screaming or not for that performance.
Everyone here was.
Everyone in backstage was screaming at all of that performance right now. Humphrey and myself included. Because oh, yeah. If there's one thing that dancers love doing, it's hyping up other dancers. And for backstage, it's like sending all of our spirit energy up on stage so you can see Matroda go even crazier. So I think that works, don't you think, crowd?
I want to see what the judges, how much energy they just got from that performance. Judges, what do we got?
So, hello, Matroda. That piece, wow, I'm trying to censor myself. I know this is a family event, but that was an absolutely insane performance. Your control that you have over your body is simply surreal. The way you're able to make these inhumane just movements from your body is a level that is really hard to match, and I love seeing that. Something I do think that you can work on is I really want you, it's right at the very end, right? Really try and hold that pose, stick that pose, don't come out until that music is done. You want to end that dance with a period or an exclamation point as opposed to a comma, right? They'll just leave more of a lasting impact on that performance. But other than that, fantastic job.
Let's hear it one more time for Matroda!
Blowing everybody's minds with just how sharp and precise all of those movements were.
And that's just not just Matroda, all these dancers have blown our minds all the time. That's why they keep coming back, or they get to make it to the show. And I love it. It's great.
Yeah, but speaking of dancers that know how to defy all logic and defy gravity.
Yes.
I think we've got another team coming up. And very this good. Team is a team that has not really been making waves at AnthroCon specifically, but if you pay attention to the dance competition scene across all of North America, you'll probably have heard their name, and more importantly, you'll probably have seen just what they're capable of. So, I want everybody to give a huge round of applause for our next team performance. Give it up for EKG!
Thinking on skies, feeling super childish, no Donald Glover. This call from my mother, like where you at tonight? Got no alibi, I was all alone with the love.
That has... Well, you made me tear up, guys. That was...
It exemplifies true romance, right there.
This is what we look for when we see... Stop crying, Gale. It's okay. It's
Gale! All right. Gale, you have your emotional support tissue right there.
Oh, so I was just told the KMEKG stands for Cry Hard.
Gale,
stop crying and let's hear what you got.
Stop making me judge the ones I'm gonna cry about.
No, oh, never.
Gosh.
Your tears are just so delicious, Gale.
Yes, yes, so salty.
Gosh, y'all. To have seen y'all go from being such good friends to developing such a beautiful relationship and being able to express your love through the art of dance is seriously incredible. Obviously, when really good friends dance, it's a whole amount of magic. But when two people who just love each other dance, it's something else.
The puppy towel was there.
Seriously, the technical prowess that y'all are showing off, your ability to correctly include your acrobatics and perform them so well, and your ability to also play off of each other's bodies and strengths is phenomenal. It's so clear that you guys are putting in so much work, and I'm so proud of you. Your journey has been incredible to watch, and we all want to keep watching it. We love you guys so much. Please keep doing this. That was amazing.
Crowd. I wholeheartedly agree. We want to keep on seeing this lovely couple for many, many more years to come.
So it's kind of funny, but next time, just make sure you don't die trying to come out of here.
Listen, I was stumbling. I was so caught up in watching that enthralling performance that, like, walking did not exist. It was like walking.exe has stopped working.
Well, it's funny because I know you and I were both kind of tearing up how wonderful it was, but I'm also seeing some of the crowd that just like, wow, that was pretty cool.
The crowd's like, I'm not crying, you're crying.
I'm not crying, it's allergies, damn it.
It's Sunday of the con, that's why I'm so sad.
So, this next answer, though, is one that will tug our heartstrings, but also make us wonder how the hell half the movements happen. And it's another one that just defies movements of the body in itself and has been on the stage with us. We love him to death. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor to introduce to you the one and only Nubtail, Strode.
Thank you.
I can tell you.
Meowdy.
You. Meowdy. But I've seen Strokes do everything from rock and roll to music. It's just anytime any music you give to this wonderful cat is just, how did they do that?
Yeah, he just takes those songs and like sends them off into space.
Yep, they're done.
And they just go out into orbit and they're done. Heck, see you later. But
at least Gail doesn't have to judge this one.
Well, and yeah, at least Gail doesn't have to cry over that one.
Yeah, no crying.
But how about we hear from another judge about this out of this world performance by Strokes, who is apparently trying to see if the lemonade's a lie.
No lemonade. Judges, what do we have?
Hello, Strokes. So, your control. Oh, that's the end of the stage. Be careful. That's a light. There you go.
Well, they knew that.
So, the way that you can have those small little ticks and pops within your performance and have them read throughout.
Hi! There's an Elijah show, hi!
Gail, control your cat.
That's not the game review.
Your parents are right there!
Oh, I forgot they were there! Keep going, Miss Gail.
This is acceptable.
I absolutely loved how you really were working that full stage. You had really good variety of movements, textures, all the sort. There was one little section towards the middle where you were sort of standing, where you were standing still, and you had these pops that you were doing. I want you, now you've done these for a while, so you probably know this, but it did not read as well, those pops did when it was stationary. So just working on having more of that emphasis, right? Because we're wearing these extremely expensive carpets that cover our entire bodies that make everything really hard to see. So other than that, a fantastic performance. Glad to see you on stage again.
Let's give it up one more time for Strokes. Actually, Ronnie.
Yeah, what's up?
Gail brought up a good point.
Yeah, what's up?
We have Mama and Papa Strokes here today to watch their wonderful
cat. Hi, Mom and Dad.
So I want to say thank you to all the mom and dads that support your friends, families, furries, and everything else that are here. Mom and dads who support and understand the way the furries are and let them be and let their artistic freedom go. Let's give one huge round of applause for all the mom and dads that support their kids here.
Been talking to quite a few around this convention, and it's a beautiful thing to hear that you've got supportive parents and those kids that are able to run around together as a family around the convention. And what's even funnier is that mom and dad usually seem more into it than the kids are.
Well, they're still wondering what in the world they got themselves into.
I mean, it's funny because I saw one day the other kid, yesterday, a kid in the dealer's den, and they were like on their phone, like, oh, are you done walking the dealer's den yet, Mom? And Mom's like, no, we gotta go shopping right now.
Yeah, I saw that too. Mom's
got like
the
best shopping trip ever. Exactly. Mom's got all the bags from all the artists she's bought from, a new tapestry, an entire new wardrobe. It's great.
And ears.
Thank you for supporting local furry artists.
Yes, yes. So who do we have next?
So, up next is somebody that, speaking of the dealers, Dan, would be someone that has a little bit of a history in terms of their species of taking coin from all of the, you know, people that have coin, which is all of you out there. And they happen to be like a miniature, more gremlin version of a dragon. I think they're like called a kobold or something.
Who are those?
Yeah. So, everyone, let's hear it for kobold!
Yeah!
and Shinies. I love it. Yeah, you did a little like fake out there, and Humphrey and I were about to come out on stage, and like you went like, no, wait a minute, I ain't Duncan, and then went boom.
It was funny because we were about to come out, we thought it was in. Next thing I know is Ronnie Noodle pushing me out. That's how I did. I'm like,
yeah, me
sorry.
Just going like, you deal with the audience. I'm gonna go home.
So what do we have for Kobold, judges?
You bring the energy every time you dance. A few times I've seen you dance, you keep improving and improving, and I love it. The only thing I'd say to work on is use the entire stage. You stayed a lot in the middle and over to the right a little bit, but other than that, it was awesome, and I'd love to see more from you.
As would we.
All right.
Let's give it up for
from behind any of the ticket counters, please. Thank you very much.
Why would you give them the thought to do
that? Okay, there they go. They took all the coins. They're going to deliver it to their dragon overlord, I guess.
I will bill you later for that.
Listen, we dragons don't take any responsibility for anything we do, but we will take money.
That's so all I hear. Is that right?
Yeah, all the dragons understand.
But this next performer... I heard that. This next performer... Their performances every time is worth all the money that you can see, but that's kind of everybody because they're all amazing. But I'll just let them show it off because there's no words I can really say how wonderful this dancer is. Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Lazuli.
For those of you last night, again, that were at Floor Wars, Lazuli was one of your judges for Floor Wars as well, and coming out here again to perform a second time. So, crowd, what did you think of Lazuli's performance?
Well deserved. Every time that Lazuli comes out on the stage, just keep an eye on it, because you'll always learn something new from how wonderful they are. Judges, what do we have for the lovely Lazuli?
The lovely Lazuli, indeed. Such smooth, powerful, impactful moments and movements throughout your routine, like even right from the get-go, again, just absolutely throwing in that attitude in some great choreography to set the tone for the entire routine. I really appreciated and enjoyed some great moments and combinations in the second part of your routine where your energy just really exuded throughout all of your moves and all of your limbs. And it contrasted well with some of the kind of the smoothness, like smooth like butter movement that was at the beginning. And And I really enjoyed that contrast in the texture and the choreography there. It's clear that you were very confident in all of your choreography, confident in what you wanted to put on the stage, and you had us absolutely glued to your performance throughout. So thank you so much, Azuli.
Let's give it up one more time for Azuli!
I like that. That sounds like a really nice way to just be like, la-la-la-la-la-la-zuli. I'm going to keep that from now on. Sorry, Lazuli, that's my new name.
Yeah, you got a new tag now.
Yeah, exactly. Well, this next performer that we've got coming on the stage is, well, I don't know, Humphrey, you remind me again. Well, what are you, director of the Game of This Coming?
I am the... reluctant. No, I am the director of public safety for this event.
Okay, so you like to keep people safe during the conventions. They have a good time, right?
That's what I was voluntold to do. Yes.
Voluntold, exactly, because you told me volunteered for it. So, have you heard any reports of, like, you know, people being stuffed in lockers at this convention?
God, no, but thankfully I haven't.
Well, here's the thing, is that you might not have heard the reports, but I have like this sixth sense that's tingling in me because I happen to be a nerdle, like a nerdy noodle. So I'm a nerdle. And I heard that this next dancer has like this really, really strange addiction to stuffing nerds into lockers.
So I've heard that, but a nerdle sounds like a Pokemon.
I don't know. So I guess I should probably introduce them really quickly and then probably as quickly as I can.
Yep.
Because I'm sure I'm the next victim for none other than Ozone!
Whether they're putting people in lockers, apparently,
hey,
that
hey,
I don't
hey,
hear of.
Hey, Humphrey, is
yes.
it safe to come out now? Is he gone?
Is he gone? Yeah, he's gone.
Yeah, okay. Whew. I thought I was really going to get my lunch money taken from you then. Oh, he's still there.
And apparently in a state of, oh, there he is.
Oh, no, I wasn't looking at you. No, please don't take my homework or make me do yours.
I thought it was lunch money.
Lunch homework money, all right? Lunch homework
weird.
Money.
Judges, what do we have to say about Ozone?
Oh, Ozone. Oh, man. I love that when you dance and that when you are romping around, not only are you big, dumb jock bro energy, you also got that cheerleader energy in you. Yeah. Yeah. the way that you can just be masculine as all heck and throw out and then be like, hey, and throw out some of the moves that you throw out is incredible. Every single time that you dance, you tell a delightful story. You know exactly what you're doing with your mix. You clearly practice your choreography, and you come out here and you give an excellent performance every single time, executing it so well in a super thick Digigrade suit while wearing an actual varsity Letterman jacket.
Yeah. And that's not fake, that's a real thing.
Yeah. I mean, your stamina is ridiculous. Dude, I have so few things that I could nitpick on that. I mean, every now and then, sure, I'd love to see slightly more extension of the arm while walking or something of that effect. But seriously, you're phenomenal. You're incredible to watch. We love you so much. Go beat up that nerd behind you.
Oh, shoot. I'm gonna let my assistant director take care of that report. I'm not even gonna worry about it.
Hey, Gail! I thought we were friends.
We're friends. Thank you. This crowd's like, I guess you were friends.
It's funny to watch nerds get beat up.
Gail's got some personal demons on that one. We'll go ahead and just keep going outside of that. But I'll take care of the report. We'll be good.
Yeah, I gotta nurse my bruised ego right now.
Aww. Just have some noodles. They're fine. Our next dancer is actually another group, and I have not had a chance to really see it, but when I saw the entry video that they did, blew me away. But I cannot wait for you to see them. Ladies and gentlemen, the Cat and the Kaiju. Woo!
Just a day, you hit me with a call to your place. Ain't been out in a while anyway. Was hoping I could catch you throwing smiles in my face.
Romantic talking, you ain't even got a job. You're cute enough for me tonight. Looking at the table and I see the reason why. Baby, you live in a life, but baby, you ain't even right. Champagne, you drinking with your friends. You live in a dark, boy, I cannot pretend. Sin. If you've been in your garden, you know that you can. Call me when you want, call me when you need. Call me in the morning, I'll be on the way. Call me when you want, call me when you need. Call me, I'll be on you, I'll be on the way. Like,
so excited, you're like, I can't believe I did it!
Oh my gosh, I'm so cool, I got boogers in my nose again. They got the wigglies in their nose again. It's like what happened that other year. Yeah, they got the wigglies.
Oh, those are
placement noodles. Okay,
they love you so much they wanted to be like you.
There we go. More noodles. Hey, judges working.
Judges, save me. Tell me something.
Okay. So, hello, the cat and the kaiju. I'm happy to see you on the stage. So, I really love the partnering work that you did. I can tell you all been practicing that really well. Your entrances and exits for them were very clean. I very much appreciate that. One thing I want you to work on choreographically, when you are having individual choreo, that is perfectly fine to have when you do have two individuals, but I would like you to find a way to have there be more connection between the two so it doesn't feel like two solos are going on the stage at the same time, right? So just working on that connection between the two. Other than that, absolutely love this performance. Thank you so much.
Or is it like kaiju and noodles? Or is it a cat and a noodle?
Is it a
noodle cat? Is it a kaiju noodle?
No, it's a canoodle.
It's a canoodle!
There you go.
Yay, canoodles!
We made a new species, trademark.
There we go, yeah. I'm definitely going to copyright that and commission art of it later.
All right.
Oh, man.
Who's our next dancer?
Well, our next dancer coming up on the stage is back to our solo competitors.
Yes.
And this one, every single time they come onto the stage, they seem to bring back, I guess, what you would call the return of the monkey. So, some of you out there knowing about the return to monkey, and this next dancer is the pinnacle of what it means to return to monkey, because it's none other than Beta Monkey!
Figuring that.
I'm like, hey, look at me, I am tree, I provide you shade and fresh air.
all the noodles falling from the sky. Our next dancer is going to be showing you some moves that have blown minds for a while, but I'm so glad they're on the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, Gnar!
Let's go, Gnar!
Hi, I'm Owen. I'm a Pathfinder. I won't let you down, except by falling. Remember me, friends. I may kill you.
An NPC now.
It is an NPC. Hi, NPC.
Judges, what do we have for Gnar?
Gnar, it's such a wacky combination of cute and just creepy all the way throughout, and just really like drawing us in from one to the other, back and forth. It was just really, really well executed, so smooth throughout. I really love the shapes that you really wanted to execute with your arm and leg extensions, such incredibly important and balanced foot placements too throughout your choreography. When there were a couple of moments where your feet were ahead of the music a bit that I noticed, but for the most part you had high confidence in your choreography. Loved the chest pop and the way that your outfit helped accentuate that really well. I thought it was just such a clever way to just draw us in to your mix. So thank you so much.
Let's give it up one more time for Gnar!
With the cute, creepy, funky, freaky mix that I totally understood all the references in there. I'm totally not a nerdle. Hi all the other nerdles out there. So,
what do we have next?
Yeah, me and all two of the other nerdles that are out there.
Nerdle.
Yeah, not wordle, that's a different thing. Nerdle, it's different. All right, but there's other aspects to being a nerdle, as I would know, that include knowing how to dress like a nerdle as well. And this next dancer that we've got coming up is somewhat of a connoisseur, and they have put it in their name themselves that they know how to really exude a sort of style that really wows everybody. And no matter where they go, no matter what they do, they are sure to impress. And I'm sure many of you will remember them when I introduce to the stage, come on out, Dapper!
Everybody wants them endlessly. Catch a tear and everyone lets them play.
dapper performance.
It was indeed, and that's also a very dragony, noodly performance.
Ooh.
Yeah, exactly. Everybody, see, everyone's buying into the noodle agenda. It's working. All of you are next. Yes.
Thank you.
Yes. That was a yes in dragon speak.
Judges, what do we have?
I am such a fangirl of yours. I freak out every time you dance. I love watching you dance. Strobes knows that I cannot stop talking about you. I love when you dance out of suit at Floor Wars. I love when you dance in suit so much. You just have such a very you style. You know exactly what you want to do, and you do that, and it's incredible to watch. You are a beautiful dancer. You tell a story throughout the entire thing. You blend this contemporary style with these technicalities, and you always are doing something new. You're always adding something fresh that is just so delightful to watch. Again, I feel like all I can do is do small nitpicks. My small nitpicks are sometimes your really precise small movements get lost just due to the size of your paws, and that's a difficulty of the fursuit, but if you're paying attention, you see them and they blow your mind. So just keep doing what you're doing, Dapper, because you're an inspiration to many. Thank you so much.
The Dapper performance of Dapper!
Absolutely! With the Dapper style, if I do say so myself.
No.
What? I'm just trying to make sure that everybody knows that the noodle agenda is working.
It is working.
And yes, it is.
Run away. Run quickly. Our next dancer is another one of those. We've had a few of them today, and in the Phantom, they're amazing. Just how their body contorts. You might know who I'm talking about. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the one and only Flinch.
Get it, baby.
To be seducted by a bat on stage this weekend, so I can say that happened. One of the things I really want to say, the way you your resistance is what really stood out to me the most within this performance. When you had moments where it was going fast and you'd slow down and then you'd have that like sharp hit was stuff that really, really stuck out to me, and I really loved watching you. And you were doing it in multiple different parts of the piece, which I really, really enjoyed. It shows really nice control of the movement itself. I also love how you were being very playful with it, especially with, you know, the bone hand, the leg. If there's one thing I could say, because you did utilize a lot of stage right, right? I want you to also utilize, because you showed that you can do a lot of movement within this style, also utilize the other side of the stage as well. So that way you're getting a full audience, and that way it's not just the people over here that can see it more. It's also a horror show for the people on your left as well. You had a fantastic performance. Thank you so much.
Let's give it up for Fletch.
I'm getting scared by some of these performers that are coming out, not just because...
There it goes.
Oh, there we go. Yeah, the bat got lost on the way to the lemonade, apparently.
Sonar's interrupted.
Yeah.
Who's our next dancer?
Our next dancer is somebody that has a lot of energy that they want to provide here on the stage, as if you haven't already had enough of it, but they're giving it out so much energy that they're actually going to be giving it out on a downbeat. So everybody, please welcome to the stage, Downbeat! Judges, what did we think?
Yes, as Ronnie said, you kept up your energy pretty much the entire time. I loved the little character things you threw in there with the like the bar game. Like you moved your head with it, and it was really smooth. Your spacing was really good. I loved it.
Hey, if enough is said, then enough is said, because I'm sure the crowd loved it, right, crowd? You love it? Absolutely. Great job again, Downbeat.
Woo. That was awesome.
Hi. Hi.
You're good to go.
The stage exits that way.
Bye.
Good
job. Good boy. So, this next dancer that we have, we're going to move along, we're a little bit going slow, but While we were there, we found out that this dancer was banned to the reps of the Delms of the Demons to be ever smelling like cinnamon.
Yeah, it's weird because when the portal opened up backstage and they stepped out, it was all like, why does it smell like Cinnamon Toast Crunch?
It did. Cinnamon Toast Yum Yum.
Yeah, but here's the problem is that while they might smell like Cinnamon Toast Crunch, I think they tried to eat me last year on stage.
He did.
Just like earlier with Ozone, I'm going to have to make this intro really quickly and then run off stage before they get a chance to have a noodle lunch.
Okay,
so everybody, please make a huge amount of noise for Kyrie!
I was very amused by the juxtaposition of like the happy roller coaster carnival behind, and then this like gave me like ultimate like animatronic vibes, which is great.
Whee!
Yeah.
Whee! And then death.
As always, Kyrie, you have a really amazing command of your character, of your overall performance. You know the small movements that you can make that really help elevate exactly what you want the audience to see. The things that come to mind for me are, let's see you more on the ground, let's see you more on the air, like let's see more of the monster that can be beyond just strictly just arm movements. A lot of the way that the music was choreographed to was on a lot of quarter or half beats, which like build the anticipation inside of us, build that sort of like, oh my gosh, what is he gonna do next? But there were moments and opportunities to be able to go with faster syncopation in there potentially. But it all goes with your character. Like you gave an amazing creepy character dance. So thank you so much for bringing that very unique style onto the stage.
Let's cheer and get rid of Kyrie!
Is right now with the level of monster, because that's only like mildly death inducing.
You're
no, no,
asking
any
for
ideas.
It.
Don't get any ideas. We don't need you any more death-inducing than you already are.
Yeah, I don't want to fill out any reports. Go away.
Yeah, eat the Humphrey.
I'm not doing a report. Go away. Go back to your
Don't eat the. Don't eat the noodle. Eat the
You're
Humphrey.
Cute.
No, get out of here. There's a flag of Kyre. Oh my god, all right, oh man, they must have a death wish. Anyway, our next dancer is going to come out and they're going to wow you. They always do every time. They make such beautiful motions using all the tools to their disposal. Ladies and gentlemen, my honor to introduce Killer DeVille.
Guess whose music I don't have? Doo-dah.
Oh, no.
Quick, send it.
What happened?
I don't have their music.
You don't have the music?
Nope.
Oh, okay. Well, how about, in this case, Killer DeVille, I'm gonna have to hit the rewind button. Is that okay with you, Killer? We're gonna just figure out this technical difficulty that was probably caused by that demonic portal opening backstage. We're gonna blame that, and it still smells like cinnamon back here. So, in this case, can we double check if we've got perhaps our next performer ready?
Yes, we are ready to go.
Oh, so we've got our next performer, and we want to give them a special introduction because, well, now they're stepping into the place of Killer while we figure out a minor technical difficulty. So in this case—
I blame you.
Yeah, you can blame the demonic portal in the back that smells like cinnamon, okay? That's Kyre's fault.
He scares you.
He does scare me. But in this case,
here we go.
Let's hear it. Wham, everybody, for Chips!
Single time. Judges, what do we have for Ships?
Hi, Ships. You know, I got all sentimental with you yesterday. Watching you grow has been mind-blowing. Like, you put in the work. You have been killing it. You've gotten an instinct, in floor wars, here, You clearly have made dance such an important part of your life, and it shows. It's incredible to watch. Like, you have such this aura about you that it's just, it oozes confidence. It oozes you knowing what you want to do when you are dancing, and it is...
Not that tight. You okay?
It is amazing, amazing, amazing to watch. I will say one of the only nitpicks that I have for you is it's really, really hard when you are partialing in a suit that has such big pieces because it's obviously some stuff gets super lost with a big pieced suit.
For free!
Bunny feet for free! But seriously, just keep practicing in the suit and remembering, okay, I need to overemphasize that, or if I want to highlight something real small, make sure when you're doing it, also your ears aren't covering it. Because bunny, you have big ears. But Chimps, gosh, keep doing what you're doing, because it's freaking amazing.
Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Chimps! I got bunny heads. All right, well, Ronnie's going to be trying to figure out the issue we had earlier, but I have another dancer that's going to be coming out to the stage, and this creature, Gail knows, I know, I think JD's been attacked by him before, I'm not sure, but when I say this name, I know the roof's going to blow off this place. Ladies and gentlemen, the terror of my eye, Raze!
Who's up there? Cougar and Merlin and Maverick and Goose? Great. Maverick and Goose. Qualifications as section leader 3 times, put in hack twice by me, with a history of high speed passes over 5 air controlled towers and 1 admiral's daughter.
I like me now, I like me now. Hey, where'd you get that body from?
We gotta hear from our judges in terms of how Raze's high flying performance felt. Judges, what do we think?
Hi, Raze. Hello. Thank you. So, I really, really enjoyed this performance. I thought you had a lot of fun. I could tell you had a lot of fun out there. One of the things I really want to make sure that you keep in mind for future, when you're doing those quick little foot movements, make sure those are within the timing of the music, because your upper body would be in time, but the lower body and those steps would be slightly off. and the timing of what they were doing, right? So whether that was like the side-to-side steps or like those little kind of like mambo steps that you were doing across the stage this way. Other than that, what I would say is I absolutely love your energy. You always bring that to the tens. Absolutely love, adore. And I really enjoyed this performance, and I see you getting better with each and every one. Thank you so much.
Let's give it up for Reigns!
Reigns, the fixing Dino Dog! The destroying Dino Dog! Yay for progress! Yay! Alright,
so we're gonna try this next one again, right?
We're gonna try not just this next one, but I hate to say it, it's our last one. Oh, we've been through 25 amazing performances so far, and there's one more left, which, well, I kind of did not foresee the whole demonic demon portal thing. I mean, if you can foresee demonic portals, you need help. But,
or it could be a benefit.
Or you just need to, you know, talk to Kyer. But we're gonna try this one last time, and crowd, I'm gonna ask of you to give our last performer, truly this time our last performer, a massive round of applause. So one more time, everybody, give it up for Killer DeVille! Ended off the show. What an appropriate ending.
Judges.
We loved that. Judges, please.
What do we say?
You ended the show perfectly. You brought the emotion. You brought everything. The only thing I'd say is when you're transitioning from left to right, maybe use more exaggerated leg movements instead of just walking. But other than that, we did awesome.
Let's give it up one more time for the one and only Killer DeVille.
And honestly, I don't know about you, Humphrey, and I might be saying this every single year because we like having, you know, every year be bigger and better than the last year.
Yes.
But just from, again, the diversity perspective and how many diverse styles were up here on the stage and how difficult it is to judge all of those diverse styles.
Big time.
That is something that I want to thank our judges again specifically for being able to give such amazing critiques and show all of these dancers their expertise and their support. So crowd, can we hear it for our judges one more time?
Let's hear it for the judges! why we're up here and not there.
Yes, thank you for your service, judges. So, now that we are reaching the end of the competition, of course, we want to find out who took the top honors for both our solo category and for our team categories. So, while our judges are finalizing who took what honors, we're going to get our dancers back on stage so that you guys can get some snazzy group photos of all of them, and so that they can groove and move a little bit for your entertainment while our judges get their results. So, dancers, let's get you all back on stage.
Let's go.
And let's get some music going so we can have a busted move for y'all.
But dancers, have a seat.
Make yourselves nice and comfy. We got lots of space on this stage that has now been graced by 26 of the best performances that AnthroCon 2024 has seen.
So, a couple of quick house notes while we're getting the judges up, folks. At the end of this event, please help us out by not only picking up your trash, but making sure that you guys exit out real quick. The wonderful staff of the DLC. Let's give a huge round of applause for the staff of the DLCC for helping us out. These guys are absolutely wonderful. So, So what they need to do is they need to change it over for the next event. So if you want to get photos and everything with these wonderful fursuiters, you can do it while we're outside. I just ask that much of you. And then we can get these announced and get ready, right, Ronnie?
Yeah, I think so. Once we have our judges up here, our judges are coming up right now. Humphrey, why don't you join us back on stage?
I'll try.
Sorry.
So, just to let the crowd know, for this year, we had three teams that basically constituted our team division, and the rest were solo competitors. And the way that we are distributing the honors for this year, we're going to have our best of show team winner going to the winning team, and then we're going to announce our top three solo division placements. So I'd like, right, if possible, maybe over here, if we could get our judges to come a little bit closer to the front. Cole, if you would be so kind to make a little bit of space for our judges. Oh, that's Humphrey.
Beep, beep.
Yes, you can take Humphrey's toes. Those count as coins, too. All right. So we have a little bit of space for our judges here. And who do we have to announce our team winner? Do we know judges?
Yes,
I will. Oh, so JD will. Well, I can give you mine. Yeah, I'll give you mine. All right, well, trade. So, JD, would you like to announce who in Anthicon 2024's dance competition took the best team winner award?
Absolutely. First, really quick, audience, what did you think about that dance competition? We've been doing these kinds of things for over a decade and a half now, and I remember back when like I was part of organization teams starting, just the dream of having dancers collaborate together and put absolutely magical things onto the floor, absolutely entertaining things onto the stage, has always been a big dream of mine. So it is with great honor and privilege to be able to announce this year's Anthicon team performance winner. Can I get a drum roll, please?
Drum roll, please!
The winner is EKG! Y'all did so amazing. All of our groups did so, so well.
Yes.
The first placement for this year goes to EKG. Congratulations. Here are your trophies. Please freak out less so you can get your trophies.
They have a piece of room history.
Congratulations, y'all.
Let's give it up one more time.
What an absolute testament to the passion and the love that these teams have for each other. I could not be more proud of those two right there, Igen and Keto, and they're just gonna get better and better. Please don't break those trophies. I paid a lot for them. Thank you. You can love them, just not that much.
Until they throw them at you.
All right, anyway. So let's get on with the solo divisions, because I know that the staff here is antsy for us to get out. But our solo divisions, we have our top three performances, and who do we have to announce our third place?
In third place is someone that I absolutely adore watching. They take my breath away every time I see them come up on any stage that they're on. So can I please get a drum roll for third place?
Here we go, drum roll, drum roll.
In third place, we have Matroda.
Yeah!
Go Mom, third place.
Go Mom prevails again. All right. Congratulations to Matroda, especially with that goated performance.
I'm glad
Listen,
it happened
and
in the end.
That all for 10 minutes backstage, all right?
All right, what do we got next?
Hi.
How are you?
I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm splendid. I cried a lot. It was rad.
Yeah, I can see the mascara running down. That's pretty cool. So, we'll fix that in post.
Yeah.
So, who do we got for our second place winner?
Gosh, this was so tight. This was an incredible competition. Everybody did so unbelievably well, and it was extremely hard to judge. But the person getting second place is more than deserving of it, let me tell you that. It was truly something so special to watch. Can I please get a drum roll for second place?
Here we go.
In second place, at Anthicon 2024, we have Wolfgang!
Woo! A well-deserved second place at that for that beautiful, heartwarming performance.
And just to remind everybody, this is Wolfgang's very first Anthrocon 2.
Yeah.
An absolute stellar performance.
All right, so one thing before we announce first place, real quick. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to row just the loudest roar I can hear. Let's give it up for our AV team for this amazing help. Thank you to all of this team. Thank you for everything. Now, the moment you all have been waiting for.
And joining me on stage is none other than last year's winner, Kaden, aka Mezcal. And would you care to do the honors of announcing who our top winner is this year?
I would love to.
Take it away, Kaden.
Can I get a drum roll, please? The winner of the Anthrocon 2024 Fursuit Dance Competition is... Strong!
A well-deserved first place. Mom and Dad jumping up, cheering.
I just saw Dad immediately go, yeah, that's my boy! And that is what we love to see.
It is.
We love supportive parents.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us. My name is Humphrey.
Please have
a great time at the rest of the convention. Please drive safe if you are leaving, and if not, enjoy the rest of your convention. Thank you again.
We will see you next time.
Next year.